Hello, gamers, and welcome to ZGC. My name is Zirillius, and today we're playing Evolution 2 Battle for Utopia. Well, it's not so much playing as it is going over update details, as you can see on your screen. We got a what's next picture, and oh my goodness, this update is gonna be juicy. But before we get into all of that, if it's your first time here or you haven't done it already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button along with that notification bell. That way you never miss an upload going up on the channel. And you can follow me on social media, Discord, Twitter, Twitch, Facebook, all that good stuff. Links will be down there in the description section. And I do want to apologize to you, the viewers. I'm sorry not much went out last month. I mean, bunch of defo videos. There's like five straight defo videos. That hasn't happened in a while, but I kind of burned myself out last month, and on top of my old military injuries, they've just been kicking my butt, you know, these past couple of weeks. So, and I also started playing Days Gone, and that has held a lot of my attention. So, but yeah, I'm trying to get this hashtag new stuff series started back up. I mean, there was a good four games I wanted to do videos on last month, and I only did videos on two of them, and then a couple more popped up, and it was just like burnt myself up out trying to record and edit all that stuff. And then a couple of the games just weren't even video worthy. One of them is video worthy, but I can't restart it because I did a test account on it and it won't reset the game for me. So I've just completely forgone that. And yeah, it's been rough, and there hasn't been much going on in Evolution, just the events and everything. And speaking of Evolution, Evolution 1 will be coming back too. Like I said, my focus just got torn away from the stuff that makes this channel the channel, you know. So this month we're gonna go ahead and kick it off with the Evolution 2 video and get this ship righted. And with the hashtag new stuff, I still want to do it, but I think I'll do it on like a bi-weekly basis or a monthly basis, something like that. So just one or two new games a month. But with that apology out of the way, let's get into the details of this upcoming update, which I'm dubbing the Digital Crisis update, and you'll see why in a second. So they plan to add a new regular event against the Dominion forces with this upcoming update. They also are making changes to the Altar of Psi clan battle, and there will be a new weapon and new types of synths to fight. So new Dominion troops, pretty much. So that's pretty much the overview of this video. So let's jump right into it with the brand new event, the Digital Crisis. As you can see there, that's Blake and Hank taking out Dominion forces, or ready to fight some Dominion forces. So, to actually partake in the Digital Crisis event, you will need to have completed the Dominion Gate, which is the very first Dominion stage. So, if you're not there yet, get there so you can start getting the rewards from this brand new event. So it'll be similar to like the Great Siege or the Great Slaughter, where you do a stage, you get points, and you get rewarded for that. So it will take place in a new location. Now, they don't make it clear if this new location is going to take up one of those last seven sector slots, but we will get a new battlefield called the Synth Factory. Three levels of difficulty, just like the Great Siege, and we'll meet familiar enemies as well as new ones, and the enemies will actually be equipped with chips, which is going to be very, very interesting. I'm guessing it's going to be like the base chips, the chips we can put on our base units and everything. So that's going to be... But the players in the clans tournament will take place during an event, kind of like the Great Siege and Great Slaughter. More points, more rewards. You know, and we will also find the parts for assembling the assault or the Dominion assault rifle, Crystallite, and chimps among the best rewards. And I'm hoping there'll be like a new chip with this, but the end reward will be a random rank A chip, which is not too shabby. And again, you'll be able to find parts for assembling the Dominion assault rifle. And each digital crisis event will last for 4 days. So very, very similar. Just think of it like the Dominion version of the Great Slaughter. That's pretty much what it is. But the enemies will have chips on the higher difficulties. And, you know, you put it on that hardest difficulty, you get the most points. And I'm pretty sure there'll be all the purchase stuff we can get and everything, extra tickets and extra runs and premium pass for that. So, I mean, this is becoming a very expensive game if you're paying for all this stuff every month. And I imagine all that stuff will be $10. So $10 for the tickets, $10 for the premium pass. So that's $20 per event, three events. That's $60 plus premium, $60. Like, yeah, it's getting crazy. If you're not a big spender, pick and choose what events you want to do. So the Dominion assault rifle will get during the Dominion digital crisis. Yeah, Dominion digital. But once we get it assembled, it will start at rank S, which is just amazing because it means we won't have to spend Crystallite to get it S rank, which makes me very, very happy because Crystallite, you cannot produce enough of that fast enough. And the new weapon features the Tachyon Convergence special ability. What will happen is it will get a cumulative rate of fire bonus every time Blake takes damage up to 200%. So those extra mag chips, if you got those, save them for this rifle, especially if you plan on using it. I do plan to get it because I need a good energy-based assault rifle. So I plan on going for this and trying to get it on within the first couple of events. So, and I'm pretty sure just like the Great Slaughter and Great Siege, which is going on right now, they will come once a month. So it'll probably, if you're not spending anything, it'll probably take you a few months to get everything or to assemble that weapon and everything. But you know, it's just one of those things where you either spin and get it right away or you don't and you just wait. So, with that, that's all the update details. Like, I know it's not much. It's good, but it's not much, which is kind of why I was like putting this off. They announced that the new update was coming last week and they only posted two things last week and one thing yesterday. Like usually when an update is coming, they post stuff every day on the update and they just haven't been doing that. So stay tuned. We should have some more news on Friday. They did say it will come out in a fortnight in May, which is 2 weeks. So expect this update to hit sometime next week. I have no idea when that will be because I just don't know how many new enemies they are and if they're going to give us details on those enemies. Usually when they do that, they do the enemies one by one, but I can see them grouping them up into one update. And you can get all of this information from the devs' Facebook page, which that link will be down there in the description as well. That's where I pull all this information, all the screenshots and everything from. So yeah, if you don't want to wait for one of my videos to get this information, go over to the devs' Facebook page and leave your comments there and everything. But I hope you all have an awesome day. And I'll see you later, gamers.